Good morning, everybody. How everybody feel? Everybody all right? All right. This is Valencia Fragrance Company coming back to you with another video. And today, ladies and gentlemen, we got something special for y'all. Definitely something special. A lot of people has been asking us about this, you know, but again, it takes time to make a fragrance, you know, or to make your version of a fragrance, I should say. It takes time. You definitely want to get it right. You don't want a half step. You want it to last all day, and you want it to smell as close to the original as humanly possible. So yeah, a lot of things takes time. We've been trying to get this fragrance. We definitely got it in. It's right here. You can see the box. It's a box. Okay. UPS just dropped this off. The box. And we're going to get into how this fragrance smell. What is going to do for you once you put it on? Who makes this fragrance? Where did it come from? And all the notes of the fragrance. All right. So first and foremost, let me hit off my new subscribers. Okay. Slick Vic 1. What's up with you? Welcome to the channel. Making you famous. Making you famous. Making you famous today. All right. We got another one. Taha Megori. What's up with you? Making you famous, making you famous, making you famous today, All right, we got Brandy Moore. What's up with you? Making you famous, making you famous, making you famous today, And guess what? We got another one. They said we had one more, didn't I? Well, we got one more on top of that one more. London, what's up with you? Making you famous, making you famous, making you famous today, All right, peoples. Now, we're going to have our best friend, Knifey, open this box for us. And I said, we're going to have our best friend, Knifey. Okay, there you go. That's how you do things. Okay, open this box for us, and we're going to get things rolling. Okay, Knifey, say what's up to everybody. Everybody, this is Knifey. Remember, he's not a player. He just cut a lot. All right, Knifey, out of my shot, do your thing. Now, while Knifey do his thing here, cutting with precision, we're going to talk about what's going on in the world, okay? Now, I just read an article a few days ago, okay? And the article stated that a father, this is allegedly, okay? A father kidnapped his daughter. His daughter was only 10 years old. He kidnapped her, sexually assaulted her, okay? And the police end up, this is in Texas, the police end up catching up with them, and the daughter was in the vehicle, okay? And what happened was, you know, the father had exchanged fire, allegedly, with the police. And the father had, allegedly, again, a shotgun. Well, the daughter end up getting away. Daughter seen the police and end up getting away. She ended up running to the police because, you know, she knew that she would get away. She knew that she would be in good hands with, you know, the police. The police knew that they was looking for her. They knew the young lady was in there. I mean, they seen the young lady get out the car, the 10-year-old girl. So as soon as the young lady opened the car door and took one or two steps, the police end up killing the father. Okay, the young lady had on what seems to be, or what looked like it was a bulletproof vest or some type of tactical vest. Okay, we'll say that, a tactical vest. Okay, why did the police kill and shoot that little girl? Explain that to me. Now, bad enough, she's been kidnapped by her father. Allegedly, it's been bad enough that she's been sexually assaulted by her father. Allegedly, it's bad enough. Now, this young girl, she's 10 years old. I'm quite sure she's scared out of her mind. Police all over the place, flashing lights, daddy speeding, double barrel shotgun going off. She looking for a way to get out. She looking for a safe haven. Definitely wasn't the Texas police. They shot and killed the 10-year-old girl. Now, what excuse can you use to justify lethal force on a 10-year-old girl? I'm going to go through this very quickly. Okay? Worst case scenario. Worst case scenario, people. Let's say that 10-year-old girl had a bomb on her. Okay? Daddy somehow strapped a bomb on her. Allegedly. Let's just say allegedly. Let's say that happened. Couldn't tase that girl? Couldn't tase her? I mean, I don't. She's 10 years old. I don't think she knew 2.5 million votes going through a system, you know. It's a 10-year-old girl. I mean, if a 10-year-old, let's say the vest didn't have anything in it. It was just a tactical vest because for some strange reason, the father didn't want his daughter to get hurt, even though allegedly he already hurt her in more ways than one. You mean to tell me, as a police officer in Texas, you're not trained to take down or subdue? I don't want to use take down. It's too strong of a word. To subdue a 10-year-old? If you cannot subdue a 10-year-old child as a grown police officer, then you don't need to be in any type of law enforcement. You need to be maybe a greeter at Walmart. That might be too much for you. But I was dead. That was fairly. I was deeply saddened by that story because it's just a loss of life that is uncalled for. So prayers go out to that young lady's family. You know, hopefully they will be accountable for their actions. Okay. All right, let's move on, people. We got the box open, as you can see. We'll go ahead and spray in the box. Spray everything down. 70% alcohol. Y'all like how I do that. Y'all like the sound effects, don't you? Don't be copying my sound effects. All right, we got the invoice emailed to us. So what is this that we've been raving about? What is this that everybody has been talking about? All right, we're going to take this out. Put that right there. We're going to throw this box over here. We're going to take care of that in a minute. All right. What is this? We're not going to tell you yet, but let's check for leakage. Is it leaking? Look like it was starting to. Look at that. Look at that. You see that? See, now it's in, this camera's in, it's in 4K, so, you know, you can pick the settle picturits and pixels in the light, okay? Picturits, okay? Don't copy my word, picturets. But yeah, it was leaking a little bit, but it didn't leak down the side. It looked like it was beginning to leak. So, y'all, maybe we need to start back with the electrical tape again. All right, maybe we need to do that. We got a slight leakage. Here we go. Lebo, another 13. Lee Lebo, another 13 type. Peoples. Most of y'all don't even know about Lee Lebo fragrances. Why not? Because a lot of it is out of the classification of y'all income. I don't mean to be disrespectful when it comes to that. Usually you buy fragrances according to your income. If you make $20 an hour, okay, you probably buy, you know, $100 bottle of fragrances. It's usually 5 to 6 times your income. You know, that's usually the way. So you usually, if you make it $20 an hour, you usually don't go over $120 a bottle for a bottle of perfume or cologne. Now, if you know, usually if you're making, you know, that $30 an hour, you'll go ahead and up that. You know what I mean? I mean, you'll push that joint to maybe, you know, you might have a good week, especially if you get that overtime on that $30 an hour check. You know, you might be pulling in $1,500 a week. You can go ahead and buy $300-$400 bottle of fragrance. You know, that don't affect you too much. Know what I mean? That's where Lee Lebo come in, because their fragrances run between $250-$400 a bottle. Where is this company located? Is this a real company? Are they located in the United States? I mean, what do their fragrances stand for? Well, Lee Lebo fragrance company is in New York. Yeah, it's in New York. And they had been in business for quite some time. They had been in business for quite some time. They've been doing the damn thing. They have been as popular as, let's say, the Bond franchise? Not exactly. But they definitely getting up there. People are starting to notice their fragrances. They're starting to ask about their fragrances. And, you know, they is starting to attract a lot more of attention. So Le Labo fragrance company is definitely coming up. Now, what does this smell like? Well, what we're going to do, we're going to open this up. We're going to tell you what it smells like. All right? All right, let's shake it up a little bit. All right, that's enough of that. Y'all be taking, y'all don't want none of y'all taking my stilo. I don't want y'all pulling up on me of the, nah, none of that. All right, let's smell this. Oh, that smells good. Oh, that smells real good. Oh yeah, that smells good. All right, what did it smell like? It smells like it's a musk mixed with jasmine and moss, but it has a fruity scent to it. You know, it's a scent that, God dang it. Wait a minute. It's a hypnotizing scent. It actually hypnotizes you. It makes you want to keep smelling this. And I love fragrances that do that. Oh, that smells good. Oh, that smells real good. It's not a heavy scent. It's not really heavy. But I tell you this. When somebody walk past you with this on, you gonna be like, oh. You gonna be like, oh. Man, that smells really good. That smells really, really good. Now, I see why a lot of people, you know, wanted me to see if I can get this in. To see if we can, you know, we can manufacture it or get it in. Now, in the perfume version of this bottle, you know, from the company, you can look it up yourself, Le Labo. Another 13 calls for, you know, the standard ounce, 3.4 ounce bottle. I'm talking about the standard bottle. Most people buy the standard bottles, the 3.4 ounce bottles, or the 3.3 ounce bottles. That's the standard size. All right, that size. And another 13 goes for $310. Okay? Now, if you're a baller, shot caller, you can go ahead and get the 16.9 ounces for, you know, around $1,100. I mean, if you're balling, why not? $1,100. I don't think so. This smells good. It's uniqueness and... Wait a minute, I'm smelling it in the background while I'm trying to talk. Give me a moment. Oh, that smells good. That smells clean. It has a musk to it. It's like it's an addictive potion. You want somebody to be all over you with that on. I'm serious. How I know this? Now, they sent me a small sample of Le Labo Another 13. I didn't get no samples out. Sorry, peoples. It was only enough for me. Or was it? Either or, I put some on, you know, told the wife, all right, you know, I got some little shopping I gotta do, put some things back up in the house. She's like, all right, whatever, go ahead. When I got out the shower and put this on, she like, wait, what's that? I said, what's what? It don't matter what it is. I'm coming with you. I'm coming with you. You ain't going to be going out of the house smelling that damn good. I need to know what that is. So that lets you know it's already wifey approved. All right, already wifey approved. Let's get this in. That smells good. That smells real good. Mmm. Oh, man. Man. All right. Oh, man, that smells good. Give me a minute. Oh, that smells real good. We got to pull this. That smells really good. All right. Cut the scale on, peoples. Let's go ahead and pour this Lebo Another 13 type fragrance. All right. Now, why do they call it Another 13? I don't know. Maybe another 12 or another 14 failed. So they named it Another 13. Look, I don't know. Okay? I don't know at all. I'm just saying. Let's get the pouring. Oh, that smells awesome. This is pure awesomeness. When I put this on, because, yeah, I'm going to definitely put it on. Wifey say, oh, you can only wear that when you with me. Maybe. Yeah, it'll get me in a world of trouble. Yeah, it'll get me in some trouble. All right. We're going to go ahead and do 1 pound, 15.6 ounces. I got about a quarter pound in there. That's what's up. Now, what are we going to give? That smells really good. God. See, that's why they make fragrances like this. It's like a Ferrari. A lot of people ain't going to be able to afford a Ferrari. That's in the class of its own. If you ain't part of the Ferrari club, you probably can't even buy certain Ferraris to begin with. Secondly, that's how, you know, a lot of these fragrances are. It's in a classification on a class by itself, whereas it's past the general public's bank account, you know, to go ahead and purchase a fragrance like this, because everybody just can't do it. Who's going to pay $310 for a fragrance? Not many. Is it worth $310? Yes, it is. That smells good. All right, people. Lebo, Another 13. What are we going to give this fragrance? What are we going to give it? Shorty right here is a 10. Straight beast mode. Look at the beast. The beast don't play no games. He don't play no games with me. He don't play no games with you. This definitely don't play no games. You piss somebody. Now, when I piss him on, wifey wanted to go with me. Like, damn, that ain't nobody. No, see, look. That's already wifey approved. Okay? You piss some Lebo Another 13 on, you going to be approved too. I don't care what she is. And I don't care what he is. What I mean by that. See? This is a unisex fragrance. So, God, if I smell a woman wearing this, that makes you want to hug somebody. It makes you want to really just hold them and sniff them. Nah, don't do that. That's creepy. That's creepy. You should be able to smell this on that individual, but that smells really good. All right, peoples. God. That smells really good. All right, peoples, we got to get out of here. You know, I get in my nose. That is sexy. We got to get out of here. We got other fragrances coming in. We got another fragrance for women coming in that a lot of people can't get. You know, they go, here's an example. You can't go to your oil store, wherever y'all go at. If y'all don't shop with us, y'all might shop with somebody else. It is what it is. You like what you like. All right? But they're not going to have Lebo Another 13. They're not going to have Lebo line. Because, number one, they don't know about Lebo. You know? Number two, they don't know all about Lebo. Number three, they don't know about Lebo. So how you going to order something or get something you don't know about? Know what I mean? So, they're not going, 9 times out of 10, they're not going to have it. And if they do have it, they're probably going to cut it up. It ain't gonna even smell like nothing. Yes, this is a light fragrance, but that smells serious. That's a serious fragrance. This is nothing but seriousness right here. All right, peoples. This is Valencia Fragrance Company. Smell like a boss. We out. Peace.